What is up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Laughing Coyote. This is Cricket 19 Predicts. We have fixture number 26 is Barbados Tridents versus the Guyana Amazon Warriors. I think Barbados are going to win this simply because I quite like Barbados. They've got a nice side, a well-balanced side, good batsmen, good bowlers, and lots of all-rounders as well. Guyana's got a pretty decent side as well. Not saying they don't have a good side. I just prefer the Barbados side. And that's why, really, there's no logic behind it. I just like Barbados. That's it. Do let me know who do you think is going to win, though, in real life, that is. And now let's find out what Cricket 19 thinks who will win. But before we get into the game, do let me know who's going to win. And also drop a like, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, hit the notification bell. Yeah, no, I'm going to be making all the remaining CPL videos, including the playoffs. And I'm going to try some Vitality Blasts as well as some of the IPL games. PSL, I heard, is going to start back up the playoffs. I'm going to do that as well. So a lot of real life stuff to come. Also, there's, you know, things that I'm doing, fans leagues and stuff like that. Lots of cricket related stuff, basically. Anyways, let's get into the video. Alrighty then, here we go. Barbados Tridents versus Guyana Amazon Warriors at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. That's where all the remaining games in the CPL will be played in real life. I guess they wanted to create that biosecure bubble. Not the ding-dong bubble, the biosecure bubble that I hear so much about. Anyways, head's been called by Barbados, and so Barbados have won the toss. Jason Holder is gonna choose to have a ball first. He's putting Guyana to have a bat first. Jason Holder will be opening the bowling. Brandon King, very young, very talented, will be facing the first delivery. Gets an outside edge. Luckily for him, does not carry to a fielder, and he'll collect one run there first up. Right, Hemraj, what a cheeky shot now. He had no business getting any bat on that. That was way too close to his body. He shouldn't have been playing that shot. But not only did he play it, he got four runs off it. And Brandon King, with a bit of luck there, gets four. Gets another outside edge. So far, Brandon King has only gotten outside edges. Lovely. But the good thing about it for him is they're racing away to the boundary for four. First time he medals one, and guess what? Gets four more runs. Yeah. Ah, spoke too soon. There he goes. Another nick. Brandon King, the king of nicks. Now then, Hemraj is like, I've had enough of those nicks, mate. Here we go. Here's a solid hit over the road for six, 96 meters long, and it was a no ball as well. So that's seven runs off that delivery. Brilliant stuff. Now he goes over cover, clears the inner circle, gets four runs, 22 runs now. He's on off just 11, 200 strike rate to be exact. Well, now he's going at over 200, but he's not done there. No, 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 there's more. There's way more. That's a lovely shot over gully. And, well, King tried to smash that one over point and over the rope, but all he did was nicking it back to the wicketkeeper. Shamran Hetmeyer now makes his way out to the middle, trying to be cheeky, and well, he succeeds. Lovely shot. Nobody there. Very risky, but he's executed it to perfection. Now he's gone after him. Tried to clear the rope, Hemraj. Well, nope, he's not even close. That's a lovely catch in the end, and that's the end of Hemraj. A very aggressive innings comes to an end. 31 of 18 deliveries. Ross Taylor from New Zealand, the Kiwi. Such a brilliant batsman. Will he get going, though? I don't think so. He's given that one a right whack, but it's going to go straight into the hands of the fielder, and that's the end of Ross Taylor as well. Gone for a golden one, the very first delivery. That's Ross Taylor gone. Nicholas Pooran and Shimran Hetmeyer are there in the middle. First delivery, lovely shot. By the way, hat-trick delivery, but who cares? You know, he just goes for it. He just smashes it. That's gone for four as well by Nicholas Pooran. Such a solid hitter of the ball. I like him. I like his batting style. And there he goes again. I don't think he's cleared the fielder, though. But only time will tell. Well, he has not. I was correct. That's gone straight into the hands of the fielder. And that's the end of Nicholas Pooran as well. And Guyana all of a sudden, well, in a bit of a trouble. Started off well. Oh, trying to be a bit too cheeky, Sherfane. Misses it completely. But not the bowler. The bowler strikes. Look at that sharp turn. He did not expect that to turn that sharply, and that's why he's lost his wicket. Nurse has nursed him back to the dugout. Kimo Paul now walks out to the middle. Shimran, now then, he's taken him on off his pads. He's very strong there. Has he cleared him? Oh, yeah, betcha. 16, he moves on to a that chemo Paul. Now then, goes over gully. That's gone for four as well. Lovely shot. First boundary of the day for chemo. Now then, where's that one gone? That one's, that was going to go over the road for six, but that is lovely work in the outfield by the fielder. They're saving this team a few runs. They're very good. Now then, Kimo is like, you know what? I've wasted a few too many deliveries. Let me make up for it. And make up for it he does with a maximum result. 94 meters long. Now then, Hetmeyer at the other end. Is that another six? I think so. Now then, full toss. Okay. Hetmeyer's like, I'll take it. I don't really need any help, but I'll take it. 91 meters long. He goes. Lovely stuff from Shimron. Likes it off his pads. Now he's given him a bit too much room. Too wide, too short. And Kimo, well, gets four runs. He gets a boundary. Now then, that's a very cheeky shot. Goes into that backward point area. But he's played it lofty, so even if there was a backward point, that would have gone to the boundary for four. Now then, now that's a very cheeky shot. There's no set in field for shots like that. That looks a bit... Okay, he's given it. I would have given it two, but the impact looks outside of off to me. I don't know, maybe time will tell. Maybe it's umpire's call. According to the current rules, it's not out, I think, but I don't like the current rules. I think the impact rule should be removed. Yeah, as long as the ball is hitting the stumps, I think it should be given out. But that's not the rules, and according to the rules, Aleem Dar was wrong and I was right. That was not out. Now then, that one has got him. That's the end of chemo, Paul. That's the one from the back of his hand, the wrong one, the one that keeps going straight. And he's bowled a bit quicker as well, Rashid Khan. He's a very talented bowler. He's got chemo. He's gone for 24. Chris Green, the captain, comes out to the middle now. And well, first delivery. Like I said, these batsmen are very, very strong off their pads, off their legs. It's gone for six, biggest six of the day, beating it by just 2 meters, 96 meters long that is. Now, then they've got a long off. And, okay, what are they doing? What, that's out. Well then. Yeah, there was no need for that, but it's just happened, hasn't it? Yep, a bit of a blunder in the running. But it happens. Oh, that's a very lovely shot from Naveen Al-Haq. And four runs off the very first deliveries faced. Now then, off his pads. Like I said, they love the leg glances. They love the leg glances. There he goes, another four. Now then, double digits he has entered. And gets an inside edge. Off to the fielder it goes. And 155 is what Guyana have scored. So 156 is what Barbados will have to chase down. I have a feeling they're about 15 runs too short. Actually, I would say about 30 runs, but I think if they had about 15 more, they would be in a comfortable position. 30 would most certainly help them, obviously. But credit goes to the bowlers of Barbados, you know. It's not just the Guyana who, you know, didn't perform too well. But the reason behind them not performing so well was Barbados' bowling and the quick wickets they got. Chris Green will be opening the bowling for Guyana. And it's Johnson Charles and Shea Hope to open the bowling for Barbados. Here we go. First delivery. Lovely shot. Into the extra cover he goes. And that'll be four runs. First delivery. The intentions are clear. They're here to win. And they're here to do it in style. But Guyana is not going to go down that easily either. As he gets Johnson Charles's wicket. That did not spin that much. It spun a little bit. Not too much though. Johnson Charles has lost his wicket. And Kyle Myers is the next batsman to walk into the middle. Shea Hope, oh, that's straight in front. Come on, that's as straight as it gets. Erasmus should have no problem giving that out, and he has given it out. That's the end of Shea Hope. Let's hope it's not the end of hope for Barbados, though. Jason Holder comes out to the middle. Lovely pull shot on the leg side, and, well, four runs he collects. Now then, off his pads, the leg lance of doom. The most OP shot in the game. Gives him four runs. Now then, Myers, it's been a bit quiet. Four deliveries, no runs. That's his fifth. Finally gets a boundary and some runs under his belt. Uh-oh, that's the end of Myers. Inside edge, keeper, by the way. Lovely bit of work there, Pooran. You're doing great. Corey Anderson, now he's a danger man. He's a danger man. He's got, well, he no longer does, but he once had the fastest century in ODI cricket. And it was against the West Indies, the Caribbean boys. Ironically, But he goes into extra cover. It'll be second boundary of the day, Corey Anderson. Like I said, a very aggressive player, very good player. Jason Holder, the skipper, goes straight down the ground over the inner circle. And one bounce over the rope, they'll go for four runs now then. Here he goes. Corey gets another four. That's just a flick of the wrist over mid on. And there is no long gun. And so they'll race away to the boundary for 421 he moves on to now. Oh, outside edge. No slips. I'll race away to the boundary. Luck is very much part of the equation. Oh, top edge this time. Corey Anderson. Well, the luck is definitely on his side now if we weren't too sure about the last delivery. There he goes. Well, make it three in a row. And they'll go to the boundary four as well. So 40 he reaches. And Jason Holder at the other end. That's a solid blow. Hooked it off. Lovely shot. 27 he moves on to. Now then, there's a leg glance. That's the shot we all love to see because it gives, most of the times, the maximum result. And that's the end of Andy. Anderson is gone for 49. Just one run away. That was a very good seam presentation from the bowler, though, Rutherford. Getting the ball to move away from batsman just a little bit, enough to get his hole in. Well, that's just what he's gotten. I don't think that's out. Oh, Erasmus has given it out. If I was the batsman, I would definitely review it. He has reviewed it. The ball swung a bit too much. There was a bit of late movement here. Look at that. I don't even think that was in line. Well, we're about to find out. Maybe it was in line, but I don't think it's going to go on to hit the stumps. Yeah, it's barely in line, and it's going to be missed. Oh, all it needed to do was clip the stumps, because remember, the umpire's giving it out, so umpire's call would stand. But no, like I said, a bit too much late swing there, and Erasmus will have to overturn his decision. Wakanda forever. Here we go. Lovely shot into the gap. And he does well. Okay, so that just happened. He took the catch and then just threw it over the rope for six runs. Lovely, innit? You gotta love this game.
Yep.
Gets an inside edge. Jason Holder gets four runs. 47 he moves on to. 49 he's on. And there it is. Lovely shot straight down the ground. And finally, a Barbados batsman gets 50 runs without losing their wicket. There he is, Jason Holder. 50 of 33, a very valiant effort just when Barbados needed him to. It's a good shot on the offside. We'll pick up just one. Oh, no, 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 that's a mix-up. He's gone. What are they doing? You gotta love this game. You just gotta love it. Look at that. What it... What? What did I... I don't even... Well, okay, well, you know, I guess it happens. Not really. I don't think this has ever happened in real life, ever. I don't think it will ever happen. But it's happened in the games multiple times, by the way. Ashley Nurse. It's looking good. 22 runs he scored. Rashid Khan, now he can whack him hard. And they need him to, because here's the last over, which will be bowled by Chemo Paul. And there you go. Lovely square drive into the gap, but it'll just be one, maybe two. Nope, they're settling for one. So 14 required now. And five deliveries. And outside edge nearly loses wicket. Jason Holder, the skipper, not having a great time. Oh no, that's just going to be one run. So now they need 13 and three deliveries, which is very much doable. Are they going to do it though? Because Chemo Paul has done a really good job. It's just going to be one run. So 12 of two, again, possible. Holder on. Not if you hit it on the side of the blade, though. You got to make sure you hit it in the middle if you're going to get 12 of 2. It's not possible now, and he's gone for it. It looks a bit close, but I think it's a bit high, and also the impact might be outside of off stump. By the way, what a fantastic over from Chemo Paul, and the Guyana Amazon Warriors have won the game just like that by 10 runs. Jason Holder got a lovely 50, but in the end, not enough to give them the win. And how wrong was I? I thought they needed a bit 15 more runs, but whatever they've got already proved to be too much for Barbados Tridents. Do let me know, who do you think is gonna win in real life? I think this is the first time I'm doing a prediction this year where me and the game disagree. So far we've agreed on everything. But yeah, I still believe Barbados Tridents are going to win real life. Guyana is going to lose in real life. But that's just my prediction. Maybe I'll be right. Maybe I'll be wrong. Let me know in the comments down below. Who do you agree with, me or the game? Anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, do drop a like, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you get notified as soon as I upload. Also, do consider becoming a channel member. You do that by pressing that join button right next to the subscribe button. Or you can also use the link in the description if you do not see the join button. Also, make sure you follow me on my social medias. There's much more cricket to come, like I mentioned in the start of this video. Thank you for watching, and I hope I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, have a nice day.